then finally, the FBI and the customs people got involved. They'd been watching this boat. They'd been tracking the boat. The military had been tracking it with military surveillance planes. They knew everything about this deal. Coming, going, selling every step of the way. So suddenly, swoop, they came down. I'd gotten away with my money, but I found out about it when I called home. Called my dad. My dad just said, "Where the heck are you?" I said, "Someplace." I said, "I've got the FBI parked in the driveway. They're reading our mail. They've tapped our phone. What have you done?" And I was like, "Oh, this did not work." He said, "So I've got you an attorney. Go to New York." So I was in New York, got the attorney, went to court. You know, I pled out. You know, I thought, okay, you know, I'm a kid. They'll just give me probation. They'll say, you know, this was just a really boneheaded thing you did. Please don't do it again. And I'll say, oh, most certainly I won't. But they didn't. They gave me 6 years in prison. I did not do all 6 years. I did about a year and a half. But nonetheless, you know, it was really quite an eye-popping experience for me to be sort of let off in handcuffs and then, you know, instantly sent into a prison. From that moment forward, then you really have to think, what are you doing with your life? That little bit of a goal that you had a glimmer of as a kid and then you wanted to seize on as a teenager, and then you kind of lose your way a little bit as a young adult, and then you find yourself in prison. It's really hard to find any kind of glimmer of that goal again. So it was the reading in prison. It was a reading. Thank God they had a little library. And so I started to read my way through the library. I started to keep journals. And I started to just kind of practice, you know, what I was doing. And of course, prison is great in one sense, because everybody's got a story. At least they've got one, how they got there, you know. And so I would, you know, write those things down, you know, sort of in code, because you wouldn't want anyone to think that you were writing about them, because they would be suspicious that you were doing something, not writing literature, but I don't know, turning them in some sort of way. And so I did that. And that kind of sustained me. And then I got out. And as soon as I got out, then I went right to college, got involved with a creative writing program, and then literally published my first book 2 years after.